Hallöchen, liebe Freunde, hi friends, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Lynn. Welcome and thank you for joining. I would really love it if you could go down below and subscribe to my channel just to support me. Please like, comment and subscribe. That is the standard thing people say. So today I'm just going to be preparing some food. My partner has been away for like 10 days and I'm so excited that he's coming back home today. So I decided to make him something that I had made him before. So one thing about Germany I don't like is the multiple bad variety of fish that I find in the supermarket. I never feel the Geschmack. I taste nothing in fish here. So I found this Pakistani store in Stuttgart. If you're familiar with Boxa, there's this big sign where there's some fish. It's frozen fish, but it's fresh fish that's frozen and then brought here. So I made him this fish one time with ugali. And for Kenyans, you know managu. A friend of mine, Quash, hi Quash, had brought it for me when she went to Kenya. And I made it with ugali and he really, really loved it. He said we should make this fish more often. He really, really loves it. So today I want to make him the fish. And I want to attempt to make it with sweet potatoes, but I don't know if I will find sweet potatoes at Edeka. So since the fish takes the longest, we're gonna jump right ahead. I will show you the tilapia. Tilapia is my favorite fish. So let's dive into this video. Since the fish was frozen, it's very important for you to pat it dry so that it's not splattering around in the hot oil that we are going to be using. So here I cut again, like just how I see it in the market, because this helps the oil go in and for the fish to deep fry correctly. I started deep frying, guys, and every time I'm working, I like to dance around. So excuse my crazy little dance. It's just my thing. Don't mind me. I'm not a good dancer or anything. I think it's high time to flip over the fish to deep fry the other side. Whoa, look at that golden brown. Once this fish is already deep fried, here are the ingredients that we're gonna need to use. 2 small onions, 3 small tomatoes, 1 paprika also sliced. And then for spices, there's this common Royco, which is common in Kenyan households. And then in addition to that, there'll be red chili flakes, black pepper. It doesn't focus here. And then I'm also gonna be using table salt. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna use the oil that I used for frying the fish to just make the stew. I'll just put it in this big pot, and then these carrots, I'm gonna slice them and cut them with vinegar and sugar, something that I learned from my aunt who I lived with for give or take 4 years, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, let's get into this onions frying and the rest of it all to make the stew with our fish. As you can see, I forgot to put my garlic with onions, which I usually fry garlic and onion together, so I just add it here.
So you guys, I decided a little bit late on the coconut milk. I was not so sure, but I think let's just go for it. Oh, it's a little bit hard to open.
Heat a little bit. So this is the sauce. We're gonna put in the coconut milk. I'm just gonna put the entire can, the 400 ml. I'm gonna rinse out this can with some water so we get anything that's left. like so, and just pour it right in. So I don't want it to be a really like soupy kind of thing. So once I mix it like this, I wanted to add Royco, but I know when you're using coconut milk, adding Royco is not a good idea. So at this juncture, what I will do is just add some of the chili, because my partner really...
To ensure that the fish fits in the pot, I just decided to break them in half, like cut it into half, and put it into the coconut mixture. Pour some of it on top of the fish and cover it so that it can simmer and they can get all the flavors mixed up together. So since the mixture is already boiling, I will just take the spoon and scoop some of that soup, which is coconut mostly, and the vegetables, and put it over the fish, because you don't want to turn around the fish. It has too many bones. That's one of the downsides of the tilapia fish. And I just tasted it and realized the salt is not enough, so I'm just adding a little bit of salt and then let it continue to cook. So I think this is the white vinegar that I'm gonna be using in this case. First, you have to melt the sugar before the white vinegar, and then you're gonna add the sliced carrots that I made these thin stripes, and then just mix it up a little bit like this. Don't let it cook for too long because you want it to be knackig, which is like crunchy. Just mix it up around and then put it on a tray. Let it cool for a while before you put it in the fridge so that it can like not get soggy.
Just came back from Ideca actually, and I got these sweet potatoes for €4.72. Like, this is like 500 in Kenya. I wish I was in Kenya, because the sweet potatoes are so, what should I say? They have so much fiber and they're much cheaper. And these are just super expensive. First world problems. And then I bought this cheese. It's like Parmesan for making this broccoli. I'm gonna show.
The easiest way to peel sweet potatoes, first slice them before you peel. It moves faster, and Lean likes easier work.
That, like with this wooden Kenyan spoon onto a plate. You don't want too much oil, because this is just to kind of coat the potatoes with. And then what I'm gonna put inside is, I actually really figured out that if you make sweet potatoes with Timt, cinnamon, it's really, really good. So I'm just gonna put a generous amount of cinnamon. Oh, it's jumping around, it's gonna choke me. Like a generous amount of cinnamon. Then I'm gonna use the baking brush again to mix that up. Yeah, it looks kind of brownish. I just mix it up really well. And then we are gonna add in some salt. I would rather put the salt here instead of on top of the sweet potatoes, and then if someone thinks it's not enough, then they can add for themselves. So like that. And then what I'm also gonna add is some chili. Let me just figure this thing out. Yeah, some chili. Putting a little bit of spice is always really good. The foods at the same time in the oven to save on electricity. I'm studying economics for a reason. I like to save my money and not overpay if we can avoid that. So this here is the baking sheet. We're just gonna start putting in the sweet potatoes and then laying them out. And again, do that with a brush so it's not overly coated. I wanted this oil and coating to be enough for all of them. So let's try to make this work. After that, I just lay it on the...
Now all the sweet potatoes are laid on the baking sheet, and we're about to put it in the oven with the broccoli at the same time. For a little health twist, I took 5 cloves of garlic and squeezed them, and then put 2 tablespoons of olive oil in a bowl, mixed it together and coated the broccoli, which I've broken into small pieces, added some salt and pepper, and then oven bake. I preheated the oven at 200 degrees Celsius and then baked this for 20 minutes.
Sorry, again, my partner is here. I'm warming the fish. The sweet potatoes are actually done. It took just 20 minutes in the oven at 200 degrees Celsius to bake.
And now I want to remove the broccoli and put some Parmesan cheese on it. Yeah, as he's taking a quick shower, he wanted to shower after the long journey. I'm excited. I'm gonna show you what the broccoli...
See, once this broccoli have a little bit browned and around the greenish parts, that's when I add the Parmesan cheese. I'm sure someone's gonna like it because he's a cheese lover. This just looks so inviting, guys. I wish I could share.
If you have time, you could let it become a little bit more crispy, but me, I just remove it like that. So now I just put it on the plate and we can go to eat. Someone is hungry.
Endlich, das Essen ist fertig. Alle Leute, lasst es uns schmecken.
So guys, that's the end of this video. Vielen, vielen Dank für Zuschauen. I hope that you enjoyed it. Please support me by liking, commenting and subscribing. If ever you try a similar meal, let me know down below. And bis nächstes Mal. Till next time. Tschüssi. Bye.